Hello everyone and welcome to PMT College, powered by professional music technology. My name is Leigh Fuge and in this video today, we're going to learn how to play the guitar with a violin bow. For the video today, I'm plugged into the Blackstar Silverline Deluxe, which is mic'd with a Lewitt Audio LCT440 condenser microphone. My voice is being recorded with a Rode Go clip-on mic. The guitar I've chosen for this video is an Epiphone Les Paul. Now the reason for this is an Epiphone Les Paul has a carved top. Playing with a violin bow is much easier on a guitar that has a carved top. It works on a flat top guitar, like a Telecaster, but it's much harder. Having the carved top allows you to get the bow in at the appropriate angle. So this is the violin bow that I'm going to be using for this lesson. This is a synthetic one. Usually they're made from horsehair or other materials, but I've gone with a synthetic one for the purpose. So before you actually start using your bow, you need to apply some rosin. Rosin comes in a small block, and what this does is it adds a sticky layer to the hairs on the bow, which creates friction then when you rub them against the string. So I'll show you how to do this very briefly. This rosin has already been used, so it's a little bit scratched up. When you get a new block of rosin, it's good practice to just scratch the top with a screwdriver or another sharp implement just to break the surface. Then you get your bow and you just run it along the rosin back and forth a few times just to apply a couple of coats. You don't want to go too heavy with the rosin because you don't want too much friction. But when I do it, I just go back and forth a few times like this and slowly move along the length of the bow just to make sure there's a nice even coat. And then once I've got all the way to the end, I just go back again just to make sure it's all on there. So now my bow is ready to go. So tone-wise, it's okay to be a little experimental here because the crazier you get, the more fun it is. So I've actually got a lot of delay and a lot of reverb on my tone. They're all coming from the amp. You compare this with whichever effects you want. I personally find a lot of delay and a lot of reverb kind of gives you that Jimmy Page sort of vibe with the bow playing. So if I was to just play the amp on its own, this is what it would sound like. So it's a very delay and reverb heavy sound, but that's perfect for playing with a bow because it really creates a crazy sort of ambient soundscape. So playing with a bow is very difficult when you're sat down. The best practice is to stand up for this with the strap worn quite low. Now I'm not going to stand up, I'm just going to wear the guitar on my other leg for this. So the reason I've now put the guitar on my left leg in the classical position is so that I can get the bow along where I need it to go. If the guitar was on my right leg, I would not be able to do this in fluid motion. So you want to go above the pickups, I find is a good place to start. You tend to get a nice crisp sound there. The strings are a little tighter at the bridge, so it's a bit easier, but you can do it anywhere along the length of the string. So the first thing is the angle of the bow. You don't want to go straight along the strings. You want to use the curved top of the body to just try and hit the string you want. Now on a guitar, because the fretboards are predominantly flatter than on a classical instrument, it's much harder to get at the middle strings. So it's best to start off with the E strings, both the high and the low E as your starting point. So if I was going to start by playing an open high E string, I want to come in at an angle. So I don't want to go parallel to the strings, I want to sweep in at an angle with the hairs on the bow. And the same is true if I'm playing the low E. Now, because of the nature of the bow and the friction it creates, I actually get what's essentially infinite sustain. So the longer I can keep the bow going, the more the note is going to sustain. Now this is pretty cool for writing different riff ideas. So if I just play that again on the low E string, and I'm going to play a couple of different notes with my fretting hand. So I'm going to move the bow in time with my fretting hand, almost as if I'm alternate picking. So every time you go to a new note, good practice is to turn the bow the other way. So I'm going from a down bow to an up every time I change note.
Thank you.
how fast or slow I sweep across the string gives me different textures. So the slower I go, the more it swells. And the faster I go, the more intense the effect is. If you want to create some crazy Jimmy Page style high sort of harmonic sounds with this, as you're going fast on the string, slightly rotate the bow so you catch the windings on the string. So as I'm coming down, I'm going to rotate the bow slightly. So you notice as I'm doing that, I'm getting this high-pitched note added on to the note that I'm sustaining. Different intensities will give different results as well. So the softer you are, the more pad-like it is, and the harder you go, the harsher it sounds. So here's how it sounds soft. And then aggressively. So you can really have a lot of control over the volume of the note you're hearing there by how hard you press down with the bow. You can also have a lot of fun on the high strings. So if I do the same thing on the high E, I can bow notes very slowly. Or a really cool technique is you can create this sort of false sense of tremolo picking. So to do this, you get the tip of the bow and you place it just on the high E string and you do very quick, small up and down motions. That's a really fun technique to mix up with some scale notes because you can actually flow around the high E string and create some melodies. You can also create some pretty cool soundscapey textures by playing chords with your fretting hand and just hitting at the strings with the bow. You can do this either by a quick sweep across the strings or by actually physically hitting the strings with the bow as well. There aren't really any limits as to what you can do with a bow and the electric guitar. You can create some violin style textures, you can go a bit crazy and do some soundscapey stuff, or you can just create a bunch of cool noise like Jimmy Page used to do. So all in all, it's a pretty fun technique to play with. So there you go guys, now you know how to use a violin bow on your electric guitar. So try this out yourself. Don't forget, lots of reverb, lots of delay, and don't forget the rosin on the bow hairs because that's very important for creating friction. Thank you all so much for watching. I hope you've enjoyed this video. If you did, please let us know down below in the comments what you thought, and if you've tried this yourself, how did you get on? We'd love to hear what you guys have gotten up to with this. And don't forget to let us know if there's any other topics or techniques or anything you want to hear us talk about in these videos in future. Please let us know down below in the comments. Don't forget to go check out PMTV UK on YouTube for more free videos just like this. And if you're looking for a guitar teacher, please head over to mgrmusic.com. Check out the network of great teachers all over the UK. Thank you guys so much for watching. I will leave you with a bit of weird soundscapey noise. See you very soon.